Lord, thy God brought it to me. He says, it's God that did it for me, Daddy. Now watch this, verse 21. And Isaac said unto Jacob, come near, I pray thee, that I may feel thee, my son, whether thou be my very son Esau or not. And Jacob went near unto Isaac his father, and he felt him and said, the voice is Jacob's voice, but the hands are the hands of Esau. Verse 23, and he discerned him not, because his hands were hairy, and his brother Esau's hands were so he blessed him. What are you saying? He discerned him not that it was Jacob. He discerned him not. What are you saying, preacher? What I'm saying, we cannot go by how things feel. We've got to go by what we are hearing. Some of us right now, we're going by what we feel. You feel like Esau, but I'm hearing, y'all not hearing me, but I'm hearing the voice of Jacob. Listen, we cannot function in the flesh, but we've got to learn how to function in the spirit. What is God really saying? What is God really speaking to your spirit? I dare you to slap a brother and say, brother, stop wallowing in your emotions and the way you feel and what you think, but flow with what you're hearing down in your spirit. I need some fathers that will hear the word of the Lord and say, I'm looking for my son. I've got to bless him. Got to bless my son. I dare you to high five a brother and say, I got to bless my son. The Bible says that he stole the blessing. He stole the blessing that rightfully belonged to Esau. He stole it. And the thing that Esau despised, in chapter 27, you'll find that now he's crying for it. He says, he gets there and says, Father, is there a blessing for me? Is there something? Is there something for me, Lord? Do you have a blessing for me? But the blessing had already been released. And many times it caused confusion and strife in the house. It brought so much confusion. And to Esau said it like this. The Bible says that Esau said, wait a minute. In verse 41, it says of Genesis 27, it says, and Esau hated Jacob because of the blessing wherewith his father blessed him. And Esau said in his heart, the days of mourning of my father are at hand. Then I will slay my brother Jacob. So there was so much strife and so much confusion, all about a blessing. All about the blessing that had been released. The very thing that you despise, now somebody else is walking in it, and now you've got a problem. And so it literally drove, the Bible said, Jacob out of the house. He had to leave for a season. Rebecca says, and they tell their son, you leave for a season until your brother cool off, until this thing in the family is settled. And the Bible said that Jacob, he leaves, and he don't know where he's going. He's never been away from home. Can you understand? Can you imagine the fear? He's afraid. He don't know where he's going. And he don't know if Esau is going to chase him and kill him on his way to Laban's house, to Laban's house. And the Bible says it like this. The scripture says that he finds a place and he slept there. And the scripture says in verse number 11 that he slept there that night. And that night, God gave him a dream. That night, God gave him a vision. That night, God began to speak unto him. And the Bible said the heavens opened up and angels was ascending and descending. And God speaks to Jacob and say, Jacob, my God, I am the son. I am the God of your father Abraham and Jacob. And the very place where you are, the very seat that you're sitting on, I'm going to bless you because I am that I am.